What is up, everybody? My name is Wade. I'm currently a fourth year medical student at Wits Medical School, and I got in via the GEMP route. My journey into medicine is quite a long one. I'm currently 33 years old now. I wanted to get into medical school from about the age of 16. Quite simply, the reason why I didn't get into medical school straight out of school is I kind of left it a bit too late. I was quite an immature student at that age. I was more focused on friends and playing sports than actually studying. So by the time I realized that medicine is what I really wanted to do with my life, it was too late to kind of turn my marks around. So by the time I left school, my matric marks were very average at best. Wouldn't realistically give me a shot at getting into medicine in any university in this country. So it was hard coming to terms with the idea of not becoming a doctor, of knowing that I kind of screwed myself out of a position in med school just because I was too focused on playing football during breaks or during class or whatever. So that was a rough couple of years to get over that. Because medicine was no longer an option, I applied to do psychology at University of Johannesburg. So I did my undergraduate degree from 2007 till 2009. My majors were psychology and philosophy. I really actually enjoyed doing this degree. I kind of somehow put the idea of medicine to bed, knowing that it was never going to happen for me. So I focused all of my energy on psychology, and I really enjoyed the course, so much so that I did an honors in psychology in 2010, also at University of Johannesburg. Again, I really enjoyed the year. I enjoyed the workload. I enjoyed the practical component of it. And it was something that I considered for a long time, going into actually doing psychology as a profession. However, in 2011, I ended up needing to get a job. So I started working at a stockbroker in 2011. And 2011 was the year that I found out about the graduate entry medical program at Wits. The stockbroker that I worked at was literally right down the road from the medical school. So one day during my lunch break, I walked up to the school campus. I spoke to somebody in the admin department and found out all I could about the GEMP program, what I needed in order to apply, what I needed to do to get acceptance. My degree was a BA degree, so I hadn't done any of the sciences, so I had quite a lot of catching up to do. Starting from 2011, I started preparing. I had to do all of the prerequisites, the biologies, the physics, the chemistry, the mathematics, and so on. So it took quite a long time for me to do that. I was working full time. I was working about 12-hour days. I was actually working about 7 days a week at that stage because we were redeveloping our networks and all that, and it took a lot of effort. So I was working 67 days a week and trying to study part-time, so it took me a lot longer than I would have liked to actually get into medical school. I applied to do all of my courses via non-degree purposes at UNISA, just so that it allowed me the flexibility to work and study at the same time. And I eventually managed to get everything in order to do my application in 2017. I submitted my application in June of 2017 and got my invite to write the WAPT a little bit after that. But my preparation for the WAPT is pretty much the exact opposite of what I'd recommend for anybody. Because I was working at the time and quite long hours as well, my preparation was really, really poor. I would get home at night, quite late at night, and if I got through like 5 pages, it would be a lot. So I essentially left myself with 2 weeks to prepare for the WAPT. I took all the leave that I had for that year, left myself 2 weeks leading up to the WAPT, and I spent those 2 weeks studying morning till night, trying to cram as much as I possibly could. It was a absolute nightmare. I can't explain how horrible it was during those 2 weeks. I was disappointed in myself because I knew I'd kind of finally got this opportunity and I had let myself down because I'd only left myself 2 weeks to study. So it was a mad rush. I focused on anatomy first, physiology second, and I left molecular medicine pretty much for the day before the exam. So it was not a great way to study for the WAPT. I've said this before on my own channel that you need at least a couple months. You need at least 2-3 months of adequate preparation for the WAPT. You don't want to leave yourself with just a couple of weeks trying to get through all of those objectives. You'll put yourself under too much psychological stress and physical stress trying to do that. You're not going to be able to get adequate sleep in any of that. So don't do what I did. Do the opposite of what I did. Don't leave yourself till the very last minute in order to prepare for the WAPT. On the day of the WAPT, I got a huge fright. I got to campus nice and early, made sure that I was there before traffic got too bad, got myself a good parking spot. And I remember walking up to the hall on the main campus, and there were thousands of students. literally thousands of students waiting to write the exam. And psychologically, that actually set me back quite a bit. Because my preparation, I felt, was inadequate to that stage, I'd kind of left myself a mountain to climb to pass the test. And then walking up to the hall and seeing literally thousands of people waiting to write that exam, it really kind of hit my confidence. I didn't think that there was any possibility that I would be able to pass the test, let alone get an offer into the program, just seeing that many people who are striving for the same goal as you. That was a major thing. The first thing I noticed was the sheer number of people standing around waiting to write the test. When we actually wrote the test, I started off with the human anatomy component first. And surprisingly, things seemed to go quite quickly. I got through that with very little issues. So I was quite confident actually after the first component of the test. I then did the physiology component, and by that stage, I'd started getting a massive, massive headache. And the questions got substantially more difficult in my experience. By the time I got to the molecular medicine component, I had a horrible headache and I felt like I didn't know what was going on. Leaving myself just essentially maybe a day, 2 days at most to cover the entire molecular medicine, I was cursing myself at that stage. I was very upset with how I had handled myself, how I had taken this opportunity to actually get into medicine again and left myself with such a short time to study. I was very disappointed, and I believed that there was no way I would have passed that test. I can distinctly remember driving home after the test on the highway, the double-decker highway by Johannesburg, thinking that I'd screwed myself, that I'll never get into medicine. I'm going to have to wait another year, rewrite that exam, go through that again, the whole process again the next year. And I actually went to a little bit of a depression after that, because I felt like for the second time in my life, first time in high school, and now then I'd let myself down and the opportunity of medicine slide right past me. Because I was so sure that I had done poorly in that exam, I kind of wiped the idea of medicine out of my mind for a while. So when I finally got an email saying that I had passed the WEPT, I can't tell you how happy I was in that moment. I can distinctly remember running down a hallway in our office, because I was working late that night and there was nobody there. And I was running down that hallway and I was jumping in the air celebrating because I had actually passed the WEPT. And I felt like, wow, okay, I'm going to get into medicine. I passed the WEPT. At that stage, my average for my degree was 77%. My composite index was worked out from my honors year and my final year of my undergrad, and it was 77%. So I was quite confident. I thought that that's a good average. I've passed the WEPT. And finally, after all these years, I'll finally get my space in the program. I'll tell you, the worst part of that year was the waiting between getting that notification of you've passed the WEPT and finding out whether you get in or not. That period of waiting can be so lonely if you're not speaking to anybody who's going through the same process. And I definitely felt that. I started seeing people online saying that they'd received their offers in December. Couple weeks into December, I was waiting. I didn't receive any offer. End of December came, still no offer. And then finally, beginning of January, I received a notification that I was not going to be offered a place in the program. It was devastating. I was so sure in my mind that because I'd passed the WEPT and because my CI was what I thought was quite competitive, that I'd get a place in the program. But unfortunately, it wasn't to be. It hit me hard, I'm not gonna lie. It really, really hit me hard. Again, I felt like medicine, it was just a dream that I was gonna have to give up on, even though it was something that I'd wanted more than anything for so many years in my life. I felt like it was just never gonna happen. And I stopped thinking about medicine. All the way from January until the application process opened up in March that year, I was like, it's just never gonna happen. There's no point in thinking about it. I put it out of my mind and just said, okay, my life will never be in medicine. I will never become a doctor. Just forget about it and move on with your life. And it was hard to do. I was quite depressed for quite a while after that. My self-confidence took a heavy knock and I kind of lost my motivation, my meaning in life, because my meaning had always been working towards getting into medicine and wanting to become a doctor. When the application process opened up again in March that year, I was in two minds of whether I was going to apply for GEMP or not. I applied everywhere else in the country. I applied to all first year programs, But I was tentative about applying again because I'd been rejected twice already up to that stage. And I went and spoke to somebody in the faculty, and I decided after that I came and apply one more time to GEMP, but my main focus is going to be on applying to all the first year programs in the country. I didn't have to write the WAPT that year because I had already passed the WAPT, and if you pass the WAPT, you get a grace period of about, I think it's 2 or 3 years. So I didn't have to rewrite the WAPT, which was a blessing. And I focused on making sure that all my documentation was up in order for my application, that all my applications to the other universities in the country were in order. And from June until December, it was just a process of constant rejection from different programs. I was eventually invited to do an interview at Stellenbosch University of that year, 2018. I did a telephonic interview and I was offered a place into the first year program into Stellenbosch. So eventually, finally, I was accepted into medical school. I was still holding on to the hope that I would get a place into the GEMP program. But when it came to December again, beginning of December, I started seeing people get their notifications, posting online that they'd received their notifications. I still hadn't received anything. Second week of December, I saw a lot of people saying, oh, I got my application, I got my offer, they're going into GEMP, and I was hoping and hoping, and I didn't receive anything. So I thought, it's just going to be a repeat of the year before. I thought my 77% again would be good enough. But I was telling myself, it's just not going to happen. Just focus on moving down to Stellenbosch, starting in first year. Even if it takes you 2 years longer to become a doctor, at least you're on the path of actually doing it. By beginning of January, I had phoned the department and they said that they were still finalizing some applications. But I had taken up a place in Stellenbosch to rent. I had put my place up here, looking to actually rent it out where I'm staying at the moment. So I had started packing to go down to Stellenbosch. First day of class started for everybody in GEMP, and I remember writing on Twitter wishing everybody well and coming to terms with the fact, okay, it's now the first day of class, it's definitely not going to happen. It's too late, I've missed my chance to get into GEMP. It was later that day in the afternoon that I received an email and a call saying that I had been offered a place. I was actually taken aback. I couldn't believe it. I had come to terms with the fact that GEMP had passed me by again. I was going to go down to Stellenbosch and starting first year. And I received an offer on the first day of class later in that afternoon. I was told that if I can make my way to the campus, pay my acceptance fee and all that, that I would be offered a place. So I remember rushing from my home all the way to campus in Joburg, running onto main campus, paying that, and then phoning through to the medical school and waiting for confirmation that I had been offered a place and that it was for sure. I sat on campus, main campus, for a while, about an hour, waiting for the medical school to confirm that everything was in order with my application, that they had received my acceptance fee, and I couldn't believe it. I honestly couldn't believe it. My life had changed so completely in the space of a couple hours. I was ready to go down to Cape Town, leave everything behind in Joburg, and start from scratch. And then the very next day, I was allowed to be on campus and start attending class. It was an absolute tornado going through my mind at that moment. I phoned my family and told them they couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe it. I was still thinking that they were going to withdraw my acceptance, that there'd been a mistake, that class had started, it was too late, and there'd been a mistake in the application process, and they were going to withdraw my acceptance. So I went through to campus the next morning, got my card sorted out, and I remember walking into class, and the class was absolutely packed. Now, I'd missed first day, obviously, and because I had to go and sort out my student card and that, I'd missed the first couple lectures of that day. So I remember walking through the class, and it was packed. Like you cannot believe, there were no spaces to sit. So I sat on the floor for the first couple of lectures. And the feeling of being in medical school, feeling of being in a medical school class, was like nothing I could have ever imagined. I cannot explain the excitement that I had running through me that day. I was so incredibly happy to be in that place. Even though I was sitting on the floor, even though I couldn't really see and I'd missed a few classes, the feeling of finally getting into medical school was like none I'd ever experienced. And I'm so happy that I never gave up. It took me pretty much half of my life. I was 16 years old when I wanted to get into medical school. I was 31 years old when I was accepted into medical school, almost half my life. And it was worth every second of waiting. I'm not saying that medical school is perfect or that it's easy. It's definitely not easy, but it was definitely worth it. To be where I am today, I would say if you're in a similar position and you're thinking that it's taking too long and that you'll never get there, I would say never give up on your dreams. I always say, it's one of my favorite sayings, that a dream delayed is not a dream denied. My dream was delayed for 16 years or so, 15 years, 16 years. But I am where I want to be now. So it took me long, but I am where I want to be. So even if it takes you forever to get where you want to go, don't give up on that. Keep trying, keep pushing, and eventually you will achieve what you want to achieve. So, yep, that's pretty much my journey into medicine, the way it's still going at the moment. It's a long road, but it's worth every second of it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you subscribe to Celo Lekwa's channel. It's a great channel and I'm very honored to be a part of it. So make sure you subscribe and share and like and comment and do all that good stuff. And thank you for watching.
Our greatest glory is never in falling, but in rising every time we fall. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel to get more videos like these. Thank you to the new subscribers, very much appreciated.